Okay, coming back here, yeah, I think we should look at the other calls right now. A clause, actually, nobody uses clause, and many people don't even use the clause system. Well, clause practically doesn't do anything, actually. Clause FD, you know, that's all that you need to do. It's just a clause FD. Clause only is an, when the process does a clause on a file descriptor, it really means process is announcing its intention not to do any more data transfers or any more operations on that specific open instantiation. That's all it means, actually. In fact, only those programs which want to open more than N5 files in their lifetime. So obviously file table is going to become full after you open some N5 files and say, no, I want to open one more file. Then you say, okay, we're going to close a couple of files, put them back into the rack and open some fresh files. So only there it makes technical sense that I want to close some files so that I can reopen some other files. That's the only purpose of closing, correct? Obviously, that's why many programmers don't even bother about closing the files. You just open lots of files. It's like libraries that you use, no? When you go to the library for reference, what do? You just borrow this book, oh, interesting, open it up on the desk, and open one more book on the desk, and so on. And it's a quick time for lunch time. We just run off. And I hope that librarian will come around. Oh, how many books are kept open on so many desks? He will close each of them and put back into their appropriate place. He will do the appropriate close system call for those books. Librarian does that. Unix does that here, no problem. I mean, Unix has no problem about closing your files which you left open when you exited. Exit system call automatically closes all the open instantiations. No questions on that. But then the problem is good documentation. I think it is good practice to say, even in the library, you can leave the books and go. But I would prefer a more disciplined kind of a student who says, I opened a library book, I borrowed it from there. You can, of course, leave it here and go off. I suppose somebody will come in and say, hey, there is one book here, why don't we put it back? But maybe a nice, decent, gentlemanly or gentlewomanly practice close the book, give it back to him so that he will put it back there properly. So close is a more of a disciplinary or a good documentation action saying, whatever files I open, I know I'm going to close them. It's a sort of, self-discipline. That's the only purpose of that. Now, FCNTL is the next. Or maybe we can do the LSEEK first before we do the FCNTL because I require this diagram for LSEEK. So why don't we do that? Now, LSEEK is that the crazy situation where we've got some special processors which do not want to do the consecutive byte transfer from the stream of bytes in the file and they want to do the exceptional kind of transfers. That is not necessarily from beginning of file to the end of file but do wake kinds of transfers. We would like to use the LSEEK system call. SEEK practically does not do anything. See, remember, the open instantiation contains a number which is called the file position, right? This is part of the open instantiation, which is the row of that file table. The row number FD has got one column which is file position. So now, the next step, reader writes a sum call is going to do the data transfer starting from this point. So what the LSEEK really does is actually a very, very simple call. LSEEK says, I am not going to do anything but quietly change this file position number. There is one long number there. He is simply going to change that number to whatever he wants. So he quietly changes to this place. Now he say next time when you say read, he's going to transfer data from a different place. I can quietly change it to some other place and say now you say read, he's going to read from a different place in the file. So LSEEK is actually just modifying the file position itself. In fact, it should have been just called seek actually. You have to seek to a page and read, no? But unfortunately, it's called LSEEK because of historic reasons. I suppose LSEEK means long seek. Earlier, I suppose there was a short seek and a long seek. But nowadays, there is just one seek. But it's still continuing to be called LSEEK. We have to get used to the name, unfortunately. See, there's a problem with the AT&Ts. You have to get used to its name. So LSEEK is fine. So LSEEK is that long seek. It's just going to modify this file position. And we have the few instances of time where we want to modify this, right? One instance, of course, is I want to read a specific page. Correct? The parameters for this is like this. So we have the long LSEEK. LSEEK of course returns a long value. So long LSEEK of int FD, obviously you have to say which descriptor or which instantiation you are seeking. Next, second parameter is the long distance by which you want to seek. And lastly, from where is the distance to be measured? I just call it int vens. Okay. So this is the third parameter. First value of this vens itself is just a zero. The vens can actually take three values. First value is zero itself. Zero simply says that I want to go to page number 20 and read something. I want to go to page number 50 and read something in the book. Simply just skip to a specific page number or a specific byte number in the file. when the when it says zero, this distance specifies the absolute distance from the beginning of the file. So you can go to any position in the file and say the next transfer is going to be affected at seek. L seek doesn't do anything by itself. It is the next read or write transfer which is going to get affected because of the previous L seek. Okay. So that is the absolute distance specification or the absolute position. So distance is actually absolute position if whence is going to be zero. See here distance is always positive because you don't have negative positions beyond the beginning of the file, right? But then sometimes we find that it is difficult to say. Supposing I want to skip the sunset description given by Somerset Maugham, right? Now he is starting the sunset description at page number 92 and this is going to take some 4 pages. So let us just think and say which page we want to go now? Page number 96, correct? In some other book, he may start at page number 45. He's got the same 4-page description. Now, where do we want to go? Page number 49, no? 49. Hey, where do you want to do this calculation? Let that idiot do the calculation. What you want to do is, you want to skip from the current page number. Can we say, please go 4 pages forward to skip the sunset description or go 2 pages backward to read the fighting scene again? So, we have this value of whence is equal to 1, which specifies a relative distance. So, in the case of 1, when you say relative position, you can go forward n bytes or backward n bytes, right? So, this here, it can be positive or negative. Both are possible. Which positive specifies skipping forward, negative specifies skipping backwards by the number of bytes. That's the distance by which you want to skip. No questions, right? Sometimes, I just want to find Butler is a murderer. I mean, in the Agatha Christie's book, where do you want to go? To the last page of the book. One way of doing that is just find out, ask somebody what is the size of this, what are the number of pages in this book. It is 223. Then you say, please go to page number 223 and read a couple of sentences and come back to page number 1 and continue. That's a bigger bore. Because sometimes she writes books which are page 223 pages and some other book of Agatha Christie may be some other number of pages. No? All the books of an author same size or could be different sizes. Usually they are different sizes. In fact, there's only one author I know called Carter Brown. I don't know if you have read any books from him. His books are always 126.75 pages in length. Exact. So, in this case, no problem. I can always go to the 126th page and read that part. But in most of the cases, when you say I want to go, we would like to specify the distance from the end of the book. So, that is the value of 2 for the whence. When you say specify this 2, that means your starting point of the file position for the measurement of distance is 1 byte beyond the last byte of the file. It's not on the last byte. 1 byte beyond. You are starting from here and say, for example, minus 1 or minus 2 or minus 10. So, you have to give only negative distances in the case of 2. You have to give only negative distances when you say whence is 2. So, that is the set of parameters that you have. And we might perhaps look at a couple of sample invocations of this. But one thing is, see, L-seq also needs to return. Of course, when the whence is 0, whatever distance that you specify is going to become the new file position, provided it can go there, right? Is going to become that file position. We know it. Whereas when you do a relative seek, for example, using a length of 1, or you do the seek from the end of the file with a length of 2, obviously the final file position is not known. No, absolute value of the final position is not known. So, L-seq always returns the eventual file position. Regardless of how you reach there. Final page number is going to tell you. You reach page number 49 or 25 or page number 322 or whatever that is. It is always going to return back the eventual file position that is reached because of the L-seq operation. That is the return value of